Hello friends, welcome you all in my YouTube channel. Dr. D.M. Sirsat here from Department of Chemistry, Anandibai Ravrani Arts, Commerce and Science College, Vaibhavadi. Friends, today we are deal with the very interesting concept from stereochemistry, the stereochemistry of biphenyl molecule. In last lecture of stereochemistry, we have studied the stereochemistry of allene molecule. Allene molecule, it shows optical activity. Similar to allene molecule, biphenyl molecule also shows optical activity without stereogenic center, without chiral carbon. But in case of allene molecule, biphenyl molecule as well as spiro compound, there is a chiral axis, and due to presence of this chiral axis, these molecules, allene molecule, biphenyl molecule as well as spiro compounds, it shows optical activity. See, one by one. Number first is, what is mean by biphenyl molecule? Simply, the two phenyl rings joined to each other by single bond is called as biphenyl molecule. See, these two phenyl rings, these two benzene ring joined by carbon-carbon single bond, and this single bond is called as pivotal bond, and 360 degree rotation around this pivotal bond is possible, and due to this free rotation, biphenyl molecule, it shows optical activity, okay? Number first is a preparation of this biphenyl molecule. It is prepared by very famous reaction, Ullmann reaction, in which 2 moles of chlorobenzene in presence of elemental copper, it gives finally biphenyl molecule, okay? And through this Ullmann reaction, the synthesized different substituted optically active biphenyl molecules. Number first, the 2 moles of substituted chlorobenzene. Number first substituent ester group, number second substituent NO2 group in presence of elemental copper, and finally hydrolysis, it gives finally substituted biphenyl, and this biphenyl molecule is optically active molecule. Hydrolysis of ester, it gives finally carboxylic acid, and these are the different biphenyls with different substituents, and all these biphenyl molecules are optically active, okay? The next one, what is optical activity of biphenyl molecules? Basically, what is mean by optical activity? PPL means plane of plane polarized light is rotate either clockwise direction or anti-clockwise direction is called as optical activity, okay? How the biphenyl molecules, it shows optical activity? See, number first, in a crystal state, both benzene rings of biphenyl lie in same plane, but in solution and vapor phase, 2 rings are twisted with respect to each other by 45 degree, and due to the steric interaction between 2 2' and 6 6' pair of hydrogen. Means in crystal state, these 2 benzenes, these 2 phenyl rings are in one plane, but in solution and vapor phase, these 2 rings are twisted with respect to each other by 45 degree, and due to the steric interaction of these hydrogens, number first hydrogen of second position and this 2' position, 6th position and 6' position, and due to steric interaction of these 4 ortho substituted hydrogen in solution phase and vapor phase, these 2 phenyl rings are twisted with respect to each other by 45 degree, and due to this rotation, it shows optical activity. See, number second, if ortho positions of both phenyl rings are substituted by larger group than hydrogen, then it shows optical activity. If this hydrogens, either first, second, third and fourth, this ortho substituted hydrogens are replaced by larger group, any other group like nitro group, carboxylic acid group, sulfonic acid group, then it shows optical activity. Means after substitution of this heavy group, the free rotation about this carbon-carbon single bond is more as compared to this hydrogen. See the example, simple example, this red ball, green ball, again red ball, green ball. If there is a heavy substituent than this hydrogen, then these 2 rings are exactly perpendicular to each other. Means there is a chiral axis, and due to presence of this chiral axis, this biphenyl molecule, it shows optical activity. Okay. Next one is the conditions for optical activity of biphenyl molecule. There is a basic 3 conditions for optical activity of biphenyl molecule. Number first condition, at least 3 out of 4 ortho positions must be substituted. Number second condition, the ortho substituents must have sufficiently larger size, means the substituents are heavier than hydrogen. And number third condition, both the benzene rings must have unsymmetrical substituents with respect to chiral axis. See, the best example of chiral biphenyl molecule, optical active biphenyl molecule. See the number first isomer. In first isomer, first phenyl ring, there is a two substituents. Number first nitro group, number second carboxylic acid group. Same for second phenyl ring, number first substituents nitro group and number second is a carboxylic acid group. Okay, the mirror image of this first isomer is a second, and these two isomers are non-superimposable to each other, means this molecule, it shows optical activity. These are the best example of optical active biphenyl molecule. Under these three conditions of optical activity, it has been suggested that the groups in the ortho positions interfere mechanically and prevents the free rotation about single bond. Thus, two benzenes cannot become coplanar and consequently mirror image is non-superimposable. Hence, biphenyl is chiral molecule. It is a simple, these two heavy substituents, nitro group, carboxylic acid group or any other substituents, these heavy substituents of ortho position mechanically interfere to each other, and due to this interference, the free rotation about this carbon-carbon single bond, it prevents, and due to this, it shows optical activity, and this concept is called as atropisomerism. See, what is mean by atropisomerism? The optical activity caused due to restricted rotation about single bond is called as atropisomerism. In case of biphenyl molecule, basically if the biphenyl is unsubstituted, then free rotation about this carbon-carbon single bond is possible, means free rotation around this pivotal bond is possible, but there is a substituent at ortho position. If there is a heavy substituent, then the substituents of ortho position mechanically interfere to each other, and due to this interference, the free rotation around this single bond is restricted, and due to this restriction, it shows optical activity, and such type of optical activity is called as atropisomerism. See the best example, same example, number first phenyl ring, the nitro group, carboxylic acid group, number second phenyl ring, same carboxylic acid group and nitro group. Okay, is a bond between these two phenyl ring is a restricted rotation along this bond due to bulky substituents at the ortho position. This nitro and acid group, these are the bulky substituents. These two are mechanically interfere to each other, and due to this interference, the free rotation about this single bond is restricted, and it shows optical activity. And after the restricted rotation, see the molecule, number first isomer, number second isomer, and these two isomers are mirror image and non-superimposable. Non-superimposable mirror image means it shows optical activity. Then if same group substituted at same ring of biphenyl, it becomes optically inactive. Okay, see the example, best example, number first phenyl ring with two substituent, nitro group, this nitro is heavy than the hydrogen, and the second phenyl group also carboxylic acid group and carboxylic acid group. See the molecule, this molecule, it shows plane of symmetry, and due to this element of symmetry, plane of symmetry, it becomes optically inactive. See the number second example, methyl group, same hydrogen, this molecule also, it shows plane of symmetry, and due to this plane of symmetry, it becomes optically inactive, means it becomes a chiral molecule. Then theory of size group, if the substituent groups are sufficiently large, then even two groups of ortho positions, they also shows optical activity. Okay, number first condition of optical activity, at least three substituents, means at least three ortho positions must be substituted larger than the hydrogen substituent, means if there is a, but there is a one exceptions, if there is a two substituents, but these two substituents are sufficiently larger size, means sulfonic acid group, even in presence of these two substituent, it also shows the optical activity. And the number next is evidence for obstacle theory. Biphenyl diaminodiphenic acid is a coplanar and shows optical activity, but when heated with sulfuric acid becomes optically inactive. It is a evidence for obstacle theory, means simple evidence for free rotation about carbon-carbon single bond. See the molecule, simple. Number first benzene with two substituents, carboxylic acid. Number second is a primary amino group. Number second ring is the same primary amino group and carboxylic acid. Okay, biphenyl diamino diphenic acid is a non-planar and shows optical activity. Okay, see this molecule is a non-planar, means due to these heavy substituents, these two benzenes are exactly perpendicular to each other and it shows optical activity. But this optical active isomer is heated with dehydrating agent sulfuric acid, then there is a reaction between this amino group and acid group, carboxylic acid group. It is a simple elimination of water molecule, it gives finally amide functional group. Means the reaction between this two functional group and this two functional group, it gives finally amide, and this molecule, it shows the element of symmetry, means this molecule, it shows center of symmetry, and due to this center of symmetry, it becomes optically inactive. These are the evidence for this obstacle theory, means this evidence for this free rotation around this carbon-carbon single bond, means this pivotal bond. Okay, the next one is a configuration of biphenyl molecule. Is a biphenyl molecule, it shows optical activity, means it shows either R configuration or S configuration. Okay, see the configuration of biphenyl molecule, it is only one example. Suppose this biphenyl molecule, see the biphenyl molecule from this left side, then there is a number first benzene ring and there's two substituents of this phenyl, methoxy group and hydrogen, these two on plane, and the groups present on plane always on vertical line is a methoxy group, hydrogen. And the priority of these two groups, methoxy group first priority, hydrogen second priority. And from left side, the second benzene ring, at a left side there is a carboxylic acid group and then nitro group, left side carboxylic acid group and then nitro group. The priority of these two, the third priority nitro group and carboxylic acid fourth priority, means the rotation first to second, second to third, it is anticlockwise rotation, means it shows S configuration. Same biphenyl molecule, see from the right side, then number first benzene ring, there is a two groups, acid group and nitro group. These two groups are out of plane, the groups present on out of plane always on horizontal line. At a right side carboxylic acid group and left side nitro group. Priority of these two group, nitro group first priority, carboxylic acid group second priority, and then second ring, these two groups methoxy and hydrogen on vertical line is the third priority of this methoxy group and hydrogen fourth priority. Same rotation first to second, second to third, anticlockwise rotation, means there is a S configuration, means this molecule, biphenyl molecule, it shows optical activity and the configuration of this biphenyl molecule is a S configuration. Thank you very much.